This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, this is graphing trig functions 5. So far we've been working with a sine function. We're going to continue, and we're going to be discussing vertical translations of the sine function. So remember, if we just have y equals sine of x, we had a period of 2 pi, amplitude of 1, the range was in between negative 1 and 1, and these were our 5 key points here, 0, 0, pi over 2, 1, pi 0, 3 pi over 2, negative 1, and 2 pi 0, which I have over here on the graph, and then I've also done another cycle, okay, going to the left of the y-axis. So now the question is, how would I graph y equals sine of x plus 1? Well, if we know what the sine of x is, then the sine of x plus 1, we would just get to add 1 to our y values for sine of x. So if we want to know what sine of x plus 1 is, then we can take, if we put in 0 for x, we know the sine of x is 0, and then we're going to add 1 to it. So this will be 1, putting in pi over 2, sine of pi over 2 is 1, and then we're going to add 1 to it. And we will get these values right here. Notice the negative 1 plus 1 will give you a 0, and 0 plus 1 will give you 1 again. So notice the y values, right, for these x values, of this, we have the same x values, but the y values, right, the y coordinates, are all shifted up 1. They're 1 more than they were for y equals sine of x. So what does that mean over here on this graph? If I were going to plot these points, I have 0, 1. I've got 1, 2. And I've got, I'm sorry, I have 0, 1, I have pi over 2. Sorry, I said that wrong. Pi 1, so here's pi, I've put 1. 3 pi over 2 is 0, so I've got 3 pi over 2 is 0. And I've got 2 pi up at 1. So for my 5 key points, I see it's doing this. And if I kept going, really what's happening is if you look at the key points on the green graph, it's the red graph is going to have the points up 1 unit. So this would be up here. This point here will go up 1 unit. This will go up 1 unit. And this will go up 1 unit. So if I were going to continue sketching this, you can see what's going on, hopefully. Everything is just shifted up 1 unit. And there we have y equals the sine of x plus 1. Now, what's the period? The period stays at 2 pi. Nothing has changed there. And the amplitude, okay, remember the amplitude is half the difference from the lowest point to the top point. Again, that's still 2 spaces, and half of that is still going to be 1. So the amplitude stays the same. And we learned from the previous video that it's really the absolute value of the coefficient of the sine of x. So you don't see a coefficient, which means it's 1. All right, so the amplitude's 1. But what about the range? This is a little bit different. What values do the y-coordinates take on? So what's the very lowest y-coordinate? It's down here at 0, and the very highest point is 2. So the range also was shifted. Like, look at here at the range of just y equals sine of x. Negative 1 was the lowest point. It was shifted up 1. Negative 1 plus 1 was 0, which is what I see right here for the red graph. And the y value is up at 2. Now, what do you think it would be if I were to graph y equals sine of x minus 2. So go ahead and try that on your own. Put the video on pause and see if you can graph it and state the period, the amplitude, and the range. All right, so let's see. What would happen? I would shift all my y values down 2 spaces. So if I look at the green one, I'll start over here at the negative pi. Negative 2 pi. I don't show that negative 2 for some reason. So we're going to shift it down 2 spaces. And also this was a negative 2. Shifting it down, we've got here. This one gets shifted down here. This unit gets shifted down 2 spaces. This gets shifted down 1 space. 0, 0 gets shifted down 2 spaces, etc. So what happens since I already had y equals sine there, that's one way of doing it. You just simply shift down and we've got it. Now the period and the amplitude is still the same, but what is the range for this blue function? That's the only thing that's changed. That will go in between negative 3 and negative 1. The period and amplitude, the period is still 2 pi, the amplitude is still 1. Now, you might not always, you know, already have the sine function there, so how about if we just started out making a chart? How would we figure out what it's going to look like? All right, let's say you wanted to graph y equals the sine of x minus 3. All right, so I have a chart here on the left. So instead of just x and sine of x, I want to do x and the y value would be sine of x minus 3. All right, well, I know the values of the sine of x, right? If I just put in the sine of x, remember how that goes? It goes 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 0, right? That's the sine of x, but what's different here is I have to subtract 3 from each of those y values. So if you want, you could write what that number is or not. That's up to you. You could put negative 3, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 3, right? If you simplified it. So here are our ordered pairs. 0, negative 3, right here. These are our key points. Pi over 2, negative 2. Pi, negative 3. 3 pi over 2, negative 4, and 2 pi, negative 3, and that would be 1 cycle. So I'm remembering these key values I always put in for x for the sine function. 0, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and 2 pi. Could make those look a little bit neater for you. Pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and 2 pi. Okay, so we have 1 cycle, and then we could do another cycle over here. It would be continuing and we now have 2 cycles of this function. I'm going to put little arrows at the end because it really does go on forever and ever. Now it should look to you as if the sine function was just shifted down 3 units. So instead of 0, 0, notice I've got 0, negative 3, it's down. Instead of pi over 2, 1, it was this ordered pair was just shifted down 1. So some people think of it of where the actual ordered pair would be on sine x and then they just move the ordered pair down, or you could write it down over here and you can see what the y values are going to be for each of those x values. The period's still the same, right? The period is still 2 pi. The amplitude is still 1. But the range would be what? Where do the y values go from? Lowest point is negative 4, highest point is negative 2. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.